Hello from the Bureau, I'm climatologist Robin Jewell.
And I'm hydrologist Robert Pippenich. We're here to discuss the climate and water outlook for February to April. So Robin, we're well and truly into summer now. What's the state of play for our major climate drivers?
Well, that really strong positive Indian Ocean dipole and that negative southern annular mode that brought us such warm and dry conditions last year, they're both eased and weakened and turned to neutral now.
Okay, so what does that mean?
This means our weather in the coming months is going to be influenced by more local effects closer to home. This includes warmer than usual water to our west and to our south.
Okay.
When the waters here are warmer than usual to our west, it means there's more available moisture which can be swept across the country with weather systems.
Okay, and it plays into our rainfall outlook?
We see this reflected in our rainfall outlook, with a slight increased chance of wetter conditions in southwest Western Australia and also in parts of our tropical north. We still do see a slight tendency towards dry conditions in some parts of the east, but most of this map is actually very white.
Yep.
And this is something that we often see when we're not seeing a strong influence from our drivers like a positive Indian Ocean dipole or El Nino and La Nina, which are also neutral now.
Yep.
And it means for most locations, there's not a strong indication either way towards it being particularly wet or particularly dry. So what does this mean for stream flow?
Yep, our stream flow forecasts show mostly low flows across Australia at most locations. In fact, there are no high flows forecast anywhere in Australia for this period. And that's not to say that we can't get occurrences of high flow for, you know, for specific events in some places, but just on average for that 3 months, January to March, the average across that period is mostly for low. And that forecast is influenced a lot by recent conditions over the past month. We've just come off extremely low, very low flows and extremely dry landscape across Australia. And we can see this reflected in the soil moisture map here, where most of the country there is well below average in terms of the moisture content. So Robin, given these recent conditions and the relatively neutral rainfall outlook, how's temperature looking as we look ahead?
These dry soils are going to influence our temperature outlook, and with just a generally warmer climate now, this means our outlook for February to April for temperatures is of an increased chance of warmer days and nights. Right. So with an increased chance of warmer temperatures, this means we continue to see an elevated risk of heat waves. And also, although we're expecting some significant rainfall across bushfire regions this week, we still have a long way to go with the bushfire season, and with higher temperatures, we'll continue to see an elevated risk of bushfires as we move through summer and early autumn.
Right, thanks Robin. That's it from us for now. Head to our website for more information and stay tuned for our next update.